everybody. Thanks for joining in. I'm Yashi from My Captain, and I welcome you all to yet another live session by My Captain. Today we'll be joined by Shivansh Singh. He's a product designer at Flipkart, and we'll be talking about careers in design for you today. On this note, let's welcome the speaker of the evening. Hi Shivansh, how are you?
Hello. Hi Ayushi, hi. I'm not able to start my video. Can you turn that on?
Yeah, sure. Wait.
I guess once the video is on, we'll start.
Yeah, I think you can open the video now. Great.
Yeah. Can you guys see me?
Yeah, we can see you.
Great. Hi everyone, how are you doing? I think it's Friday, so everybody must be chilling, might be at homes, at their cities. So yeah, it's great to be here, you know, partner with My Captain. And so I'll be talking about, you know, how can you build a career in design? And, you know, maybe tell about a little bit about my experiences as a designer, how I got into the field, what does design mean in general? And probably, you know, how can you guys also get started if, you know, it interests you and you want to pursue it, you know, when you come out of college or you graduate. So, you know, without wasting time, I think we'll jump straight away into it. Give me a second, I'll share my screen.
Yeah, so meanwhile, Shivansh is sharing his screen. Let me give you a quick introduction. He did his engineering from IIT Roorkee, and he's been the executive member of the design team of Thomso. Thomso being the IIT Roorkee's national fest, but he did not stop there. He went on to work for GoGape, and since then he's worked with companies like Razorpay, Flipkart, and I know you're getting excited by the minutes, so I'm not going to stand between you guys. Shivansh, the evening is all yours. And yeah, if you guys have any questions, just remember the chat box is open. You can drop in there and Shivansh will take them up one by one.
Yeah, you see, I think there was a problem with me. You know, I was not able to share my screen. I think I should.
You should be able to share it now. Would you check it?
Yeah, just a second. Is it visible?
Yeah, it's visible.
Great. So, hey guys, how are you all? So let me get started with, I think Ayushi will give you a little bit of introduction about myself. My name is Shivansh Singh. I was born and brought up in Jaipur. I'm 25 years old. I graduated from IIT Roorkee in 2017. I did my BTech in chemical engineering. And you must be, you know, at this point must be thinking, you know, how from a chemical engineering background, I got into design. I think I'll park it for now and probably, you know, touch upon it later. But to tell you about, you know, my experiences in terms of design, after graduating from college, for the last 3 years, I've been working as a product designer in companies like Flipkart, Razorpay, and now Turnip. So I'll give a brief about, you know, what my role was at these companies. But just to even, you know, tell you about how I, you know, got the taste of design. That was back when I was in college, right? I even before, you know, getting into design, I was, you know, in my childhood, I was into sketching. I used to sketch a lot. You know, I used to sketch cars, you know, even some of these cricketers that I used to follow. And in my first year, I got introduced to this magazine group in our college. you have these student groups that where you know you interview and you are selected and you become a part of that group. So I got introduced to this magazine called Geek Gazette, where we were creating these magazines, you know, for geeks and nerds in our college, and that is where my design journey actually started. I didn't know any tools or anything about design in general. You know, what is design? What how do you create screens? What are the tools that you use? So the only thing that I knew was I had a creative mindset. I could think of, you know, a lot of creative ways to, you know, solve a problem. I think that is the core crux of design, right? I mean, you don't really need to learn tools. You just have to have that mindset of, you know, solving problems and looking at different angles to solve it. So yeah, I became a part of that magazine group. We were creating ads. We were creating, you know, posters. We were trying to compile the magazine in CorelDRAW, which is a tool, you know, that we used to use back then. And finally, then, you know, every semester we used to print it and it used to come out. And we used to see that, hey, our work as designers is actually going to, you know, a lot of students and people are reading those. There were articles. So just a second. Yeah. So that was where, you know, I got the taste of, okay, that this is something that is very fascinating, right? You can get instant gratification of the things that you are, you know, putting efforts into. And that is how my journey started, where, you know, after that, in my second year, you know, I got into, as Ayushi also mentioned, that, you know, I was handling our cultural fest, which is Thomso, where, you know, you used to create these posters for social media, flexes, where, you know, these celebrities, they come and perform. So everybody is seeing those designs in college, in your college. Everywhere, the whole theme of the festival is, you know, presented by you. And there are, you know, hundreds or thousands of, you know, these participants coming from different colleges, look at those and, you know, admire them or probably, you know, get some information out of them. So after that, you know, that was how I got into design through, you know, print, graphic, etc. But then I slowly transitioned into UI and UX into my third year, where, you know, we built our own startup. Where, you know, we were trying to do something in advertisement space. And that was where I was handling design for the app, for, you know, even for graphic. But that is how I got into UI UX. And, you know, alternately, I was also getting a lot of freelance projects from, you know, Internshala, from a lot of these Facebook groups. And the thing at that point was, you know, the community of design is very small. And if, let's say, you get certain work, you are recommended to some other people. And that is how I got a lot of projects to work on, be it, you know, working on dashboards or be it working on different, you know, maybe creating, you know, a physical design of a bakery shop. So these things got, you know, came along my way. And that is how I think I learned a lot in my journey when I was in college. And after that, I think when I, you know, applied for a lot of internships into UI and UX design, I luckily got around 3-4 offers. And I think that was where, you know, I was content that I want to get into design. And I think this is something that, you know, I can pick when I graduate from college. I can think of doing something full time in it. And that is, after that, I haven't looked back. It's been 3 years. You know, when I graduated from college, I worked at Razorpay for the first 2 years, where I was handling, you know, different things such as, you know, building checkout for customers, handling merchant activation, building GST invoices, which are, you know, really interesting things. Now, Razorpay is a payment solution company, which, you know, has grown a lot. And I think that was where I got introduced to design on a much, you know, greater level, or maybe I can say, you know, on an industrial scale, where how do you build products that actually touch upon, you know, millions of users. And that was where my journey as, you know, into one particular vertical of design started, Now there are multiple areas in which you can go into design. I'll talk about those a little later, but that was my experience at RaiseBay. And apart from that, I was handling evangelizing design in the team, outside as well, design hiring, team management, etc. After RaiseBay, I joined Flipkart, where I got the opportunity to work on a much, much bigger scale, where we were touching upon millions of users every day. And every small design alteration or iteration that you do have a lot of impact. And you can see it right away that your product is being used by people around you. Even you are using that product on a daily basis. So at Flipkart, I was leading design for multi-reward ecosystem, which was Supercoins, which is a virtual currency that people use. Apart from that, I was also handling Flipkart Plus, which is the loyalty program at Flipkart. So recently, I left Flipkart. Hello? Am I visible? Yeah. So recently, I left Flipkart. We are a small live streaming platform for mobile gamers. And we want to build a community around gamers from India. And at Turnip, I am leading design for everything, be it building a brand identity in front of our users, or building the platform, building the streamer toolkit, or the website recently. That's a bit about my journey as a designer in the last 3 years, or 6 years of getting to know design in general. So I think coming back to the point of how I got from chemical to design, right? I think that just happened as I went, right? I think on a contrary side, there is no, we haven't have any, design course in IIT Roorkee, which, specifically caters to, teaching you design. And there were a lot of, students who were interested in it. They started learning from, getting into internships, getting mentors, or even learning from people outside. Yeah, I think we have seen that trend in our college, that when we were leaving, we left a design studio where it was open for students from first year to fourth year. They can get into it, they can learn any type of design that they want, and it's free. I mean, it's basically a student group run by students. You can earn money out of it. You can do freelance projects. You can do projects that are fascinating, or you can understand the length and breadth of design. And I think the trends have shifted. I think design earlier in the Indian ecosystem wasn't really taken much into consideration when I talk about in terms of career. But lately, back even then, the housing wave came in, and now a lot of companies are giving design a lot of importance because of the the versatility it brings on the table, and how it can make a product from good to best. So I think design is understood as one of the core pillars of building a great company or a great product, and that is why I think this at this moment where we are in right in 2020, there are a lot of companies that are coming in. And even with the government trying to promote a lot of people to come up and start building products, start building apps out of India, I think that brings in a lot of opportunities for us to be a part of this particular vertical, and do something magical, try to create impact by building really amazing experiences and products. I think a few of them are raising hands. I think. So we'll probably take questions at the end of this webinar. That was a brief about me. I think I'll probably jump into what is design. right? And so before I do that, I think I'll probably show some of the initial work, you know, that I did when I actually started as a designer. So if you see, you know, this was the first ad that, you know, I created for the magazine. It was a Samsung Smart Cafe shop just outside our college. And we used to get some funding from them by promoting them into our magazine. And people, you know, these students used to, so that was the time when, you know, we used to get money to get smartphones. And we partnered with the store to, you know, there's a discount that students get when they buy a phone from there. And there were some other designs that, you know, I created for different articles that we're doing in different issues of the magazine. And yeah, I think I think the whole point is, now that I look back at it, I think that, oh, what an ugly design did I make. But that's the whole point of, you know, design, right? It is a subjective field. You cannot build perfect things. And the point is that you have to just start, right? You don't have to stop. You have to keep iterating, keep getting better at it. And even today, I think a lot of my work is not up to the mark. I try to iterate on it. I try to, you know, become better every day. And that works even if you're 10 years into the industry or 20 years into the industry. It is always going to be, you have to always be, you know, relevant, and you have to always be engaging, you know, in terms of design or as a designer who's building those designs. So yeah, that was some initial work that I did. And as I said, that I got into, you know, a lot of freelance projects where I was building, you know, maybe some packaging box design for this absorbent pad, or, you know, even building web pages, building ads for, you know, or notebooks where I was interning with a company. And, you know, even trying out a lot of these illustrations by replicating or imitating a lot of these designers, probably on Dribbble, Behance, etc. And that is how, you know, that was one way for you to learn as a designer, by copying other, you know, other designs or other, you know, some amazing things that you come across. It can be anything physical around you, or it can be anything virtual that somebody else has posted. So, I think the breadth of learning design is endless. I mean, you can learn through projects by taking, you know, working with companies, working with your friends to build, you know, side projects, or you can just one day go to a website, try to copy it, try to, you know, build it from scratch again. And that is the whole learning process of design works. And this is the latest work that I've done in the past 1 year, where if you see how the trends have shifted from, you know, doing a whole bunch of things from print, graphic, you know, illustrations, web, I completely moved into this field of product design, where, you know, I'm working for building apps, building platforms, and, you know, thinking on a much bigger scale, where we are building products to solve, you know, problems around Indian spaces or even abroad. So yeah, that was some of the work that I've done so far. And it's again, as I said, right, it is an iterative process. You have to keep getting better and better. And I still say this is not my best work, because I want to improve as a designer. I think that should be the core crux of, you know, if you want to get into design, you should leave that ego or that, you know, that fear of failure aside, and you should, you know, get started with it. So I've talked a lot about, you know, different types of design fields that are there, how I got into design, you know, some of these, you know, terms in design, such as product or, you know, experiences. But if I have to go back a step and talk about what design comprises of, I think, the design term in itself is much misconstrued, right? To some, the word basically describes, you know, the way things appear. For example, you know, the packaging of Coca-Cola, the bottle itself, or maybe, you know, the packaging of Domino's box. But to others, it feels like, you know, this act of creating something beautiful, like, you know, an artist, you know, laying brush strokes on a canvas to paint. I mean, you can see some of the paintings that I've done even in my background. So I think people perceive design in different ways. But although both of these interpretations are correct, but they're not completely true, right? Design is not just something, you know, something wrapped, right? It is it's a act of creating art. At the core, design is the science of organizing information as effectively as possible. It is basically, you know, it can be anything and everything that is around you, even how your phones are built, you know, the biscuits that you eat, or even how the doors are designed, the door handles are designed. If it opens inside, opens outside, if you press the door. So everything around us, right? Even human bodies are designs. And these are done in a specific manner. There is a proportion to everything that is there, but still not everything is perfect in design, right? To quote what is design, it is the invention and conduct of the subject. It is the disposition of every part and the general order of the whole. I mean, these are words that, you know, might feel, okay, that is, you know, a lot to take in, or it's not easy to understand. But to, you know, to break it down into simpler terms, design is everything that human eyes can perceive or feel. And yeah, I think that is as basic as I can go in terms of defining design. And, you know, design is impacted by every element of its makeup, from, you know, the typeface that you use, color schemes around us, its simplicity, the chaos, etc. And even, you know, if you know, I have to talk about how design is, you know, construed, or probably the different, you know, pieces of design, how it has been in ancient history, with the pyramids built around Egyptian empires, and, you know, the simplicity of iPhones, you know, today, how fluidly you can use technology, and how it, you know, touches upon that connection between humans, you know, and smartphones. I think great design can create, you know, significant cultural impact. It has been doing since the past few years, where, you know, internet came into picture, and I think the way we perceive information, or the way we interact with people, I think that has changed tremendously. I think that has design has played a major role in doing that. So So we have talked about, you know, creating, you know, impact with great design, but as I said, design is very subjective in nature, right? There is no such thing as perfect design. If you see, every tree is not the same. Every human is not built the same way. So I think if I have said that, you know, there is no such thing as perfect design, there isn't. But there is, good and bad design. And you can find it in your daily lives as well. You know, for example, if there is no indication of if the lift is going up or down, you don't know. You just press and figure out. I think that is bad design. So how do you distinguish between what is good, what is bad? There are certain 10 principles that Dieter Rams, he's a famous designer for, you know, physical products. He has come up with these 10 principles that what, signifies, or what probably, can you call a good design? Good design is innovative. Good design, for example, Snapchat, how Snapchat, transformed the way we, share information. And that was very different from other platforms. That is good design. Good design makes a product useful, unlocking your phones or using them on a daily basis just to do a call. It is a useful product to stay in touch with your loved ones. It is a good design. Good design is aesthetic. I think everything that we see with our eyes, I think the first thing that we see is, how does it look? How does it feel? That is the first thing that we touch upon. So if a design is aesthetic, it is good design, but that is not always true. Probably we'll touch upon other points as well, which will sort of, support that. Good design makes a product understandable. You don't really need to learn every time, by using WhatsApp. You just have to learn how do you type once, and then, you're good to go. WhatsApp is a good design. Good design is unobtrusive. Good design is honest. Good design is long lasting. That is how products like Instagram works, because you are hooked to them. There is a certain experience that that brings you back on the platform, and it is long lasting. You're not shifting to another platform because you love using that platform, with whatever features it has, and that is a good design. Good design is thorough down to the last detail. They won't leave out certain use cases, or they won't be designed for a certain level of users. Even a blind person can use a particular good design, that is how things are right. It should solve for every use case. Good design is environmental friendly. Good design is as little design as possible. I think that is one thing that I always go back to, which is you don't have to overcomplicate things, right? You don't have to over aesthetic something just to make it look good. I think if you can drill down onto each level that, hey, let's drill it more down. Let's try to make it as little as possible. I think that is what design is. How can you simplify things and still make them look or feel good? And there are a lot of challenges that comes with design when you say that. And that is why we as designers, right, we solve these problems. We are basically the problem solvers. Our job as designers is to sort of apply these tools that we use, be it our mind, be it our software that we use, to solve these problems. A company called IDEO, which is global design company, they apply on anyone and everyone, be it your relationship with your families, or be it spaces around you, to make a better design, right? Some of these design thinking principles are first, empathize, gain an understanding of what the problem is. Try to dig deep into why does the problem exist, who is it catering to? Why is there a problem in the first place? Define the problem, analyze your observations and synthesize them. Try to understand, get the grasp of everything that is around you. The third is ideate. Once you have that, full understanding of context, try to think of different solutions. Don't stick to one, but try to wrap your head around, okay, this could be a solution. This could be a solution. Just take, think of a problem in your mind, be it, let's say, traffic in Bangalore. How do you solve for it? I know there's a problem in Bangalore for traffic. There are a lot of people going at a particular time to office and coming back at a particular time. So I know the problem. I know the root cause. I know people are driving their own vehicles. So I understand the problem. What is the solution now? Can we make odd even rules just like Delhi? Can we, make people to use public transport? Can we make, public lanes for, public transport to go? And can we fine people? So there are different solutions that I can think of straight away, but you can never know which one is correct. So you try to prototype it, right? You try to, come up with either physical or either virtual solutions for it. You, for example, recently Bangalore, road, they have created a specific lane for buses to go, and that has, significantly improved, reduced the time from one place to go to the other. Earlier it was, let's say, 1 hour. Now it's 15 minutes. So that was one of the solution to the problem. But is it the best solution? You can only find it if you test it with your real users. And this is very important when you're actually building design, be it building a graphic, be it something that you're posting on social media, be it something that you're be it a product that you're designing. You should test it with people that you're building it for. A lot of time we think that, okay, if I am not able to use it, nobody is going to be able to use it. But that is not the that is not the case. If I can use a particular smartphone, that doesn't mean a 60-year-old uncle will be able to do it. So you have to figure out what your target users are, and then test with them, because in the end you're building for them and not for yourself. So we've talked about what design is. I think there are a lot of ways that you can define design. I think anything that I say in this 1 hour session will be less for me to describe what design is. But I think I'll leave it open for interpretation for people. Try to go around and probably observe a lot of things, because as designers, you should be good observators. You should be empathetic to things around you, to things happening around you. How do people talk? Why is a couch in a particular design? Why are doors let's say a landscape? Why are they vertical? There can be very naive questions, but answer is always good design. Talking about different types of design verticals that are there. I've talked about that, how I went from print and graphic design to UI and UX and product today. So there are different fields around design, design spans across countless mediums. Some of these paths for design are graphic design, digital product design, game design, interior design, interaction design, even physical design such as physical product or fashion design, landscape design, which is landscape design is something which is you're making your garden, or you're trying to create your own, you're trying to decorate your room. That is called landscape design. When I talk about different types of design fields, I think it's very important to understand in depth what do these fields cater to, and what kind of work do you do in these fields. I'll probably leave that for probably sessions, or probably you can reach out to me separately to understand in depth what sort of field does intrigue you. And I think there is no particular answer to which field you take. I think it's a process that you have to follow. And if you don't understand the breadth, you will not be able to narrow it down. I think that is how every other field works, where you try to understand the horizon and then probably reach to a particular goal and stick to it. And that was the case with me. And I think this is the best time for you guys to be in that position, right? You're in college, you are studying, you have a lot of time to explore a lot of things, because I think there's no particular time for you to get started with design. But I think being in college, you can understand and explore a lot of things without having that, any baggage, or without having something to hold you back. So I think I can speak from my experience, where I've seen people do a lot of different things when they're in college. And design was something that, intrigued me, and I did that. I think if I have to see this whole, the whole space, I fall into the digital product design space. But sometimes, because now I'm in a company where we're a small startup, I touch upon a lot of different things. And that is the, beauty of design, right? Everything is interconnected, right? You have to, even if you're designing a digital product, it has to sort of emulate, your physical spaces, the colors, the hues, the tones, the things that you see around you, how are they made? What are the compositions? Why are they in a specific manner? I think these things, does bring in, a lot of questions in your head every time. And that is the beauty of design that I really love. I think we've talked about, different careers in design, and, how can you get into those? I think I'll touch upon that, because I think that is a major question. And a lot of people have asked me separately, how do you get started? There are a lot of people who hesitate from starting, because either they don't have, any sort of guidance, or they don't really have that motivation to get started, right? But when most people start out, they try trying copying a lot of different designs, other designers' work. I think that is how you learn. It is not shameful. It is not uncommon. But a lot of young designers or artists, they you'll try to begin with tracing a lot of works that you look up to, or probably you explore. You come across a lot of different designs. You try to emulate them, and that is how the learning process works. But I think I'll touch upon what should you look at when you're actually doing those things, right? And there are different tips and tricks as to how can you get started with design. Even if you don't have a design degree, or even if you're from an engineering background, just like me. As designers, or even when you're starting design, copying is one thing, but then trying to understand what is happening is also important. Just a second. So I'll quickly jump into different tips and tricks as to how you can get started with design. So as I said, right, this is the best time to get into design because of various reasons, right? Be it companies starting from India, companies understanding the value of design. Even big companies like Microsoft, Flipkart, Amazon, everybody understands that if you have to get people, you need good design. And because there are a lot, the market is very competitive, and you need people in your team to think creatively, think of solutions that can make people stick. I think that was one of the major things that I have to think upon when I was at Flipkart. How can you make people stick to the platform? Because Amazon is doing really well, they can deliver in one day, but how can you make these people stick to Flipkart? Because these people, they rely on experiences. They rely on, if you can give the best to them. So how can you, give it to them? So I think this is the best time, as I said, to, get into design. You can join an online design course, or, get mentorship from people. There are different, websites or different platforms which allow you to do that. There is Udemy, there is 10K Designers, which is an initiative by an Indian designer, around learning design from mentors or courses taken by you. I think that is one of the great ways for you to learn design very quickly. And if you're not from a design background or a design school, you don't have a design degree, I think that is one good way for you to get started. Another way is to, once trying to understand the breadth of design, try to, choose the field that you want to begin, and then learn the fundamentals of design in that field. For example, if let's say you are into UI and UX, you have to learn, how does grids work? What is material design? What is the guidelines for building an app versus web? Building mind maps? How does color theme works? Right. So these are different things or guidelines around design. Be it like the graphic design. Try to understand how does typography work. What are different patterns? What's 3D? What if there are certain guidelines around UI and UX, such as understanding material design guidelines or interaction design, and yeah, I think we have to explore which field do you want to get into, and what actually intrigues you at the end. And although it doesn't really matter which tools do you use, but at the end of the day, you are actually creating virtual or physical products that people can use. And I think you would need certain level of expertise in knowing these tools. And there are different tools for you to use and get started. And it's very crucial when you're actually getting into design as a career option. For example, for graphic designers, Illustrator and Photoshop are some of the tools that you can use. For UI and UX, you can use Figma, Sketch, XD, etc. And then when you're working on different products, a freelance work, college fest, etc. I think one way to enhance your skills is working on these things. The other side of it is to, get some passive learning, which is trying to go through podcasts of different designers, read articles created by them, maybe go to YouTube tutorials of them and try to learn from those spaces. I think I've added some of these links here. I'll at the end of the session, I'll share this presentation with everyone. I think you can go through that. So there are certain books that actually help you trying to visualize the space around you, be it by books from Don Norman, like Design of Everyday Things, to Don't Make Me Think. How do you build products that are relevant, are useful, right? And then there are different articles or videos around some of these designers who are doing really interesting work, and they're teaching you design, right? For example, there is an Indian designer, if you might know, Saptarshi. He started his YouTube vlog where he's teaching different fundamentals of design. And yeah, I think you can learn a lot from these designers by following them, by following them on Medium, following them on Twitter, YouTube, etc. And so I think one more way to for you to get start your understand why things work in a certain way is look at some of these platforms that have done really well, and then at the end try to understand why do these platforms work, why do they work better than other competitors, what is that thing that actually makes them stand out, who is their target audience, why are they doing things in a particular way. I think if you ask this question yourself and then look out for answers, I think you'll learn a lot about the mindset that goes behind doing things in a particular way. Be it looking at products like Airbnb, Spotify, Netflix. Why do they excel over others? I think I'll leave it up for you to figure out, right, why do they exist? Why do they work? I think one very personal trick, I think to understand design or learn design, even if you don't pick it as a career option, I think design should be inculcated in every study material or courses. I think that is one thing that I always will speak about, because it is everything that you experience in your life, and you can only if there is a way where you can learn these things, I think that'll be great. And to apply this on your personal spaces, I think these are some examples of how I have curated spaces around me, be it putting icons on my Instagram stories, or even creating my own desk space which feels familiar, which feels like I am doing something here and it feels like home. So that is one very smart way to be involved in design, or try to make sense of things around you. I think I'll probably ask everyone here to go back and probably explore some of these platforms that you can personalize, or probably say that, hey, I have designed this thing. Think creatively. How can you if you're, let's say, interested in let's say Queen the band, maybe put a poster on your wall, maybe decorate your room. I think that gives you an immense sense of gratification, right? Even if you're not into design, because that you're going to see it every day and you should feel great about things around you. Then, follow some of these amazing designers, said, right, on social media, on different platforms, and see what they are doing. Probably ghost them. Try to see, what are the things that are working on? Why are they doing things? Probably ask them questions, DM them, or ask them questions around, okay, sir, give me feedback on this. I think there'll be a lot of designers will be happy to help you. So there are certain links of designers that I know, or probably I even follow, where, I have to ask certain things, or, I have to take the feedback, talk to them in terms of design. I go to them. So when you're actually, getting into design as a career, right? I think being in college, you need to have a portfolio built, for you to showcase your work. Because if somebody is going to hire you, they're only going to see the work that you have done. They're not going to ask you to, you know, send them you your sketch files or Illustrator files. It's the platform they'll see where you have showcased your work. And I think you know, it goes a long way in, you know, putting it out there and showcasing to the world that, hey, check out my work, probably seek feedback, ask for a lot of opinions, because that is how we learn and grow. Lastly, I think always have a mentor to guide you. And I think that is something that I have also observed, that, you know, your learning process gets fast paced if you have somebody to look up to, you know, be doing one-on-one sessions with them, be it sharing your work, you know, with them without the hesitation of, you know, getting criticism. Because as I said, design is a very subjective field. Different people will have different perceptions around things. So that you have to leave that ego behind and have to find someone who can, you know, whom you can reach out to if you want to get certain feedback, or you won't be, you know, intimidated by their feedbacks, because at the end, they're only helping you to learn and grow. And there is a platform, you know, which help you in getting guidances from you know, these awesome designers across the world. I am also getting enrolled in that. So you can, you know, explore it. You can get sessions from a lot of designers that you feel like in different fields of design, you know, and get connected with them, understand in depth about things, maybe get mentorship from them. That's it. Thank you everyone for, you know, hearing me out. I think for me, I think it has been a tremendous journey in terms of design. And because, you know, I have seen myself grow, I can see 3 years back what sort of things that I'm working on, and retrospect, what all has happened in design, how it has become more relevant, and how can I contribute to a much larger extent, right, in building these experiences around us. So yeah, with that note, I am, you know, I think I'll open it up for questions. I think should we go in the chats and then?
Yeah. Let's start with this one question. Which degree is helpful to get into UI UX design?
Okay. As I said, right, there is no specific degree that actually actually tells you that, hey, you can get started with UX design. A lot of companies these days don't really care about if you have a degree or not. As long as you have that mindset and you can solve a problem, right? In the end, it's not about the tools that you use, or probably you know, if you know how grids work. It's about if you can, you know, think of out of the box solutions. If you can, you know, try to make sense of things, try to understand the context, understand the problem, and then, you know, collectively build solutions for it.
So Himanshu is asking, what was the name of that student group you mentioned in IIT Roorkee?
The name of that group was Geek Gazette, GAZETTE. It was a magazine group. It was a technical magazine group that used to run for our college. For every semester, we used to print a magazine and we used to upload it on Issue. So if you go to issue.com, you can see all the magazines that we have done. You know, even today, there are a lot of juniors of ours who are working on these magazines. We have a Facebook group where, you know, we think around, you know, what could be the theme of the magazine this time. And give them probably advices at times whenever we get the, you know, opportunity to. It feels great to, you know, see that how even the magazine has transformed from where what we were building at that time to today.
So moving on to next question. Eshma wants to know the difference between UI, UX and graphic design.
Okay. I think at times there are you know, there is a thin line between your UI and graphic, but to I'll put these three into three different definitions and buckets. Graphic design is basically you know, these posters or you know, these things that you do see on social media, or let's say some of these ads that I showed you, even print design, everything that you make around those is graphic, right? Or everything in terms of you know, any creative thing that you can make is graphic design. And if I talk about UI, UI stands for the term user interface, which in itself speaks for right, that it's an interface where users which users can use. So any product that you make, it has a specific UI that people see. Even this Zoom call, the experiences could be that okay, that leave button is at the bottom right, but the way you see it, that is UI. And if I have to put what UX is, that is how the experience of you know, you interacting with that UI. Example, if I talk about this Zoom call, you went to a particular link to register, and then you opened a link, you got into the call, you clicked on that mute, you know, unmute button, you started your probably the session, or at the end of the session, you'll click on that leave button. That is the whole experience from, you know, your starting point to end point. And that is what we call UX. So to put it in, you know, very simpler terms, I think if you see, you know, a human body, your skeleton or the structure of your body is UX, UI is your clothes. And I think if I have to put it on probably a layer more, UI could be your body, right? You just the skin of your body, and graphic could be the things that you probably add on top of it.
So you've already mentioned that degree is not that important, but what about when you want to apply to large companies like Flipkart? Do degrees matter then? And our next mentee is asking that question.
Sure. That's an interesting question. I think if you see a lot of companies that are coming up, definitely degrees don't really matter. Probably, you know, in interviews, they give you an assignment at times. And then if you do really well in those assignments, if you're able to explain, you know, your thought process or what exactly did you come with proper logic and reasoning, I think that is the only thing that matters. But definitely portfolio is something that becomes a screener for any company to sort of shortlist you for interviews, right? If I have to talk about, even though I worked at Flipkart and I don't have a design degree. And I think at the end, as I said, right, a degree can only help you to a certain extent. It can only teach you, you know, some fundamentals around design. But the end, it's you're working on physical products, right? So I think the experience that you get there is very different from you get, you know, when you're actually you know, studying for a degree or for a certificate. So in certain companies, it definitely matters. Colleges matter if you are from an NID, or let's say if you have a certain, you know, expertise in human computer interaction or not. But personally, I think if I worked in a small startup to medium scale startups to big companies like Flipkart, but I haven't, you know, faced any, you know, problem in, you know, even I haven't seen people saying, ki, hey, you don't have a design degree. And I think it's just a thought process, and your passion for design matters.
Right, exactly. So Dhanashri wants to know about the design lab that you mentioned was present at your college.
Okay. So it is a design studio. Just call it, you know, DS Studio. And that basically, you know, how it originated, you know, we were in our third year where, you know, we became a part of this student mentorship group where we were mentoring first year students. And, you know, there were only around, you know, if I have to, I can count people on my fingers who were into design. And we used to tell people about, okay, design a certain thing that you can do. And we saw a lot of response from these first year students, where when we were in our first year, we didn't even know there was a thing called design that existed, right? And I think that is where even we had a discussion with our juniors, and when we were leaving college, we thought of, okay, let's set up this group, because at the end it's run by students only. There is no there won't be a course brought in by the administration, because I think that is a long shot. But we can definitely create a student group to put an impact, make people get that platform to learn design. They can get mentorship from some of their seniors. Even they can get freelance projects, and that is, I think, the best way to learn. So
okay. Well, I think that answered your question, Harashri. Moving on to the next question, Ashna is asking, how to pursue post-graduation in UI UX after BCA? Any college recommendations for us?
Okay. So I think to sort of do courses or probably degree in design in terms of UI UX, I think some of these important, so these colleges in India that are really great are NIDs are there. Even IDC Bombay is really great. So I think you can get into those. And I think a lot of companies, they do give importance to these colleges, and a lot of companies go to these colleges to hire people, right? From what I've heard, or probably I've seen a lot of colleagues of mine who are alums of these colleges, I think it goes a long way in enhancing you as a designer, and learning those fundamentals of design, be it UI, UX, or be it any other design. And they have all sort of courses from retail design to graphic design to physical product design. And you can choose the course that you want to be in. There is a specific exam that you have to give, and then that is how you enroll into these colleges. So I think if I talk about India, I think NID and IDC are some of these bigger colleges from where you can get these courses.
So Dhanashri has another question for you. How much is coding important for UI UX designing?
I think this question is very, it is evergreen. I think it has been asked a lot. I think I'll probably add to it, right? Do designers need to write content? I think I'll answer to both of these things, because it has been asked a lot, right? No, you don't really need to learn coding to be a designer, but I think you should have some sense of how things work, how grids work, how different screen resolutions work, right? How do you design for, let's say, a Pixel 3 versus, an iPhone? So, because at the end, you're interacting with these developers, to export things, export screens. And if you don't talk in their own language, you will feel lost, right? It's equivalent to how you empathize with users, right? You get into their shoes and then talk to them. That is very similar to how you work with stakeholders. You try to get into their shoes, talk their language. Like if I, today, if I am on a call with my mom and I start speaking in English, she won't be able to talk to me, that comfortably. But if I talk in Hindi, she will be very fluent in talking to me. So I think that is the barrier that comes in. So if you understand how pixels move, or what is the platform that you're using, how does APKs work when you download them on the app, I think these things actually go a long way in maintaining the rapport with the developers. So coding is not really important. You just have to learn the fundamentals of how things work. Talking about content, I think that separates you from a decent designer to a great designer if you're writing your own copy and not using some lorem ipsum, right? And I think that if you're writing your own copy, that you know gives you also a sense of what is happening. Can you understand that content that you're writing? And that saves you that extra step of, you know, going back and probably thinking of copy again. And then if that, let's say something breaks off because of the copy in design, you have to go back and do it. So I think content also is not really important for you in design, but I think it gives you an edge over other designers.
Okay, moving to the next question. So Priya would like to thank you for the super informative session. And she's asking, do you necessarily have to be great at drawing and sketching to go ahead with design?
Okay, interesting. Actually, I think that depends on the field that you're in, right? Although design, you know, in any design is a creative field. So there is a certain requirement of, you know, if you're able to create sketches or if you're able to, you know, draw things out. If I have to tell you right now to probably, you know, draw a flower. I think as designers, there is a certain knack of creativity that is required, right? Because that is something that is driving you to become a designer in the first place. But not necessarily. I mean, that is a skill that you can learn. You can, you know, take inspiration from places around you. Even let's say, I think one of the major thing in design or probably a tip in design is always look at things around you or in nature. You know, when you're thinking of colors, when you're thinking of compositions of things, and then try to emulate in things that can be relevant or that can be contextual. I think that way you don't really need skills to creatively think of and drawing things, right? And I think tools these days help you in tracing things really efficiently. So you don't really need to, you know, draw something out and then probably trace it and then draw it or probably, you know, finalize it or visualize it. Yeah. And yeah, thank you for, you know, you're hearing me out. I think, yeah.
Okay, so this another mentee is asking that they're pursuing their bachelor's degree in computer science, but they're very much interested in graphic designing. So would you suggest some interesting courses that they can go with so that they can pursue both the degrees together?
Okay. Interesting. So I think one way is to look at, you know, you can definitely get into courses and you can get these, you know, certificates from, I mentioned Udemy is a platform where, you know, you can learn graphic design or, you know, another way is to sort of, you know, follow a lot of graphic designers who are famous, you know, who are relevant, who are doing a lot of amazing things. Probably follow people on Behance or Dribbble and see what sort of work they're doing in graphic design. You know, be it, you know, building 3D rendered models to, which is relevant these days, to, you know, very simple drawing based illustrations, you know, or creating these social media banners. How do they do it? You know, graphic designers who are famous are everywhere on Twitter, everywhere on, you know, social media. One of the, you know, graphic designers that even I follow is, you know, Pablo Stanley. He's not just a graphic designer. He does a lot of things, but then at the end, I really admire his graphic design. So I think, although I haven't taken any courses, so I can't really recommend any, you know, graphic design course, but I think you'll find a lot of platforms like Udemy where you can get those courses.
To the next question, do you suggest a beginner to start building upon the portfolio? Does it have to be strictly aimed at a particular kind of design or can it be random?
Can you repeat the question again?
So, do you recommend building up the portfolio since the starting, and does the portfolio have to be based on a specific kind or can it be random?
Okay. I think it depends on what is the field that you're applying for. If let's say you're applying for an internship in, let's say as a general designer, then I think you have to showcase your skills. it's basically, you know, you are a fashion designer, you know, putting forward this fashion show, right? You have to, you know, put forward everything and anything that, you know, helps you in getting that recognition or getting that, you know, visibility that, hey, as a designer, I can do a plethora of things. And if you today go to probably my Dribbble or Behance, there was, you know, endless things that I did. And I put everything there because, you know, at the end, if you're doing a lot of things, why not, you know, showcase it? And coming to the first part of it, do we really need, you know, need to get started with portfolios right away? Not really. I think first try to understand design and try to, you know, replicate a lot of things, try to iterate. And then once you are satisfied with it, that, hey, it looks good, at least to me, it looks relevant. That is where you post it. And I think with a lot of people, as you, you know, get into, you know, the career side of things, it sort of leave your portfolio behind because you don't really get time or it becomes irrelevant because you're not applying. And a lot of designers these days, you know, they only create portfolios when, you know, there is a need for it, when you're actually applying somewhere. I think that is where you should not follow that. You should be relevant. You should keep on updating your portfolio because I think it is not just about, you know, you getting a job. It's also about you learning through that process. And I think that if there's a place where you can see where you started and where you are today, I think you can tell that, hey, I've learned and I've grown.
True. Moving to the next question. This question is basically an extension of a previous question.
Okay.
Along with coding, do you have to be good at HTML for UX design?
Okay. So coding basically comprises of, you know, if let's say you're building for web, or let's say you're building websites, then some of the coding languages are HTML, CSS, JavaScript. So HTML is a part of that. I think if I have to answer it personally, no. Even yesterday, I built a website on this platform called Webflow, where I don't really need to learn HTML. I can, you know, I made that website just with design and understanding of, you know, these guidelines, grids, you know, typography, font, you know, what font size works best in phones versus on web. How does grid spacing work, 12 versus 4, et cetera. So I think that's all that matters. And I think a lot of tools and platforms these days help you in building websites or building apps without any, you know, coding required. Yeah, you don't really, HTML is a part of coding. And I mean, personally, I think I never learned, I did learn, I think HTML, CSS in college, but then I think I thought that is not my cup of tea. And but yeah, I think I still have understanding and fundamentals of it.
Okay. So do you recommend joining a design school after the college?
If you think that a design school is, you know, is really good, I think the first question that comes in is it worth the time that you're investing in it? Try to thoroughly research, you know, the design school. See the alums of that design school, where they are, you know, placed at the moment, and probably talk to, you know, some of those. You can easily get in touch with those people, and, you know, try to learn from them what is the thing that they learned the most out of this design school, and how is it different from what, you know, how is it relevant now in the things that they're doing in the company that they're placed at. So I think if it makes sense for you to, you know, you think that, you know, a design school can be a good motivator or it can push you to learn things, I think definitely go for it. I think that will enhance or probably, you know, fast pace your learning process because they can teach you a lot of things in a shorter time frame. Yeah. Shiv, I'm not able to hear your voice.
Yeah. Can you hear me now? How to pursue graduation in UX and UI design?
So, as I said, right, I think there are different colleges in India that actually help you, you know, in getting these, you know, courses, or even there, these are mostly colleges that you can enroll in, and they are physical colleges. While there are also online courses and certificates that you can take, be it, you know, human computer interaction, or be it courses on, you know, Udemy, Coursera, and other platforms. Even, I think Design Norman Group also lets you get certificates in specific design fields. And yeah, I think that is, I think I've already answered this question earlier as well. So,
yeah. Okay. Vanshi wants to know the difference between NPD and design thinking.
Okay. I don't really understand the term NPD.
Vanshi, would you please explain what you mean by NPD? Okay, meanwhile, we're waiting for an answer. Let's move on to the next question. What did you said about gaming counseling and earlier as an online gaming streaming? What were you talking about that?
Yeah, so I think if I recall correctly, it was about the company that I'm working for as of now. Basically, I'm working for this startup called Turnip. We are a live streaming platform for mobile gamers. You can start streaming any game on your device. You can reach out to your audiences by, using a tool that we provide. So, yeah.
Okay. So we have another question for related to degree. But this time it's about product designing. Is any degree mandatory for product designing?
As I said, not really. But then I think even when we were hiring at Razorpay or Flipkart, I think that becomes a barrier for us to shortlist people at times. Where if let's say if somebody is from a design school such as NID or IDC, the understanding of core concepts of design is to be taken as more, because they are taught in a particular environment, they're taught very specifically about those things for let's say 1 year, 2 years, and although that doesn't really mean that they are superior over others, but that slightly gives you an edge when you're actually applying for, bigger companies, because there it definitely matters. And that is a distinction that even I think that is, baseless. And you don't really, judge people on the basis of the courses that you take, or probably the degree that you have, or the college that you've been to, because design is a field which is very creative, right? It is something that comes to you naturally. So even if it doesn't come right, you can always learn it. It's not something that if you don't really have a creative mind, you cannot learn it. It's not that. You can always go for inspirations at places. You can talk to a lot of people, get feedback from them, get guidances if you are stuck somewhere in a complex solution. So yeah, I think you don't really personally. I think you don't really need a degree, but for product design, again, as I said, IDC is definitely one of the top colleges in India that provide you a degree.
Okay. Dhanashree, I think Shivansh has already answered this question. We'll share the recording with you if you've missed it. That's not a problem. Moving on to the next question. Why did you leave Flipkart? You leave it?
I've recently, in last month itself, I left Flipkart and joined Turnip. I think, that's very interesting. So I think when you are actually, trying to understand what field you want to be as a designer, right? And how relevant do you want to be in design field? I think personally for me, I wanted to be in a space where, I can take ownership of not just building those UX and UI flows, but also lead things by doing a lot of different things like handling social media, for once, or maybe building a brand from scratch, you know, building design systems from you know, ground up, or maybe leading a team where, you know, even 2 years, 3 years down the line, I can, you know, lead a team of 4 or 5 designers and even mentor them or even manage the team. Think of different, you know, innovations. How can we make processes very efficient? It's not that I wasn't doing some of those things at Flipkart. I think for me, it is, you know, a learning journey where I learned a lot of things at Razorpay and then moved to Flipkart to, you know, broaden my horizon of learning. I think one of the real reasons why I joined Flipkart was because the research team was really interesting there. And I got to, you know, talk to a lot of people who are using the platform, because if you are building for, you know, millions of people, there is no one design fit all solution. You have to talk to a lot of people to understand what they're going through. I mean, you cannot sit in, you know, probably a 3 BHK and you know, understand the problems of a person sitting in tier 4 cities where they don't have internet, they don't have ways to, you know, travel and get those packets. So I think the learning and the products were really great that I've worked on at Flipkart. But I think, as I said, I wanted to, you know, be more relevant in terms of doing a lot of different things in design. I think that will be my motto for the next few years as well, where, you know, you learn, you know, continuously in that process of learning. And, you know, as I said, even earlier as well, that even if you're 10 years into the industry, right, there is no particular time where you say that I have learned everything. Yeah, I think that was the real reason why I left Flipkart.
That is like, okay, so that's about the questions, I guess. Before we end the session, is there a message you want to share with our mentees?
Okay, so I think I will probably say this, that, you know, as I said, right, this is the time for you to think of career or not. Not just in terms of if you are in college, but I think because of the lockdown as well, right? There is a lot of time at hand which you can utilize, and, you know, you can do a lot of different things, and it cannot be just design. I think it can be anything. If you want to learn something new, or if you want to probably create a lot of content, I think this is the time to do it. You can explore a lot of different things that you can do, or you can think of, you know, okay, I can do this. Probably let me try it out. Maybe I'll fail, but at the end, what matters is trying, and that is what design is. You know, just trying and trying until you get better, and not perfect, because nothing is perfect.
Right. That was pretty insightful, Shivansh. Okay, so can you please share a communication channel for our mentees so that they can connect with you after the session?
Okay. All right. So probably, I think what probably we can do is
maybe share your LinkedIn or Gmail.
Yeah. I think I've in the presentation I've added my Instagram to LinkedIn links.
Okay.
You can reach out to me in terms of any questions that you have, or if you want to get certain guidance or mentorship. Anything in terms of design or even other things as well. I'm open to, you know, answering all your questions and queries. And yeah, you can ping me on these platforms.
Great. Could you please upload the presentation?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, how do we do that? So by uploading, you mean on Zoom?
I think, no, we cannot upload anything on Zoom. Okay. We'll share
the presentation with you.
I'll share the them with the mentees. Yeah. I'll email them the presentation.
Yeah, that'll be great.
Right. Okay. Thank you so much for the session, Sachin. Thank you so much for the session, Shivansh. It was a pretty insightful session, and we learned a lot of interesting things, especially when you said that you learn from emulating other designers. That was really insightful. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for giving us your time. And thanks a lot to all of you mentees for joining us. It's been a great session. And we'll keep bringing such interesting sessions for you. Stay tuned and bye-bye.
Bye.